신청은 하고 또 문의도 하고 이렇게 답을 받고 있습니다.
부산에서 처음 시작을 했고요. 그렇게 했을 때 저희
청년배당은 한 100억 정도 저희가 지출을 했을 때 연간 일자리가 한 207개, 그 다음에 192억 원의 생산유발 효과, 뭐 205억 원의 소득 증가 효과가 있습니다. 재래시장에 가서 우리가 이제 상가가 얼마나 좀 활성화됐습니까? 이렇게 통계를 내봤더니 뭐 2016년 기준으로 볼 때 평균 한 26.3%의 증가 효과가 있었습니다. 복지와 경제 효과가 만나는 점도 있지만 청년들의 정치 참여, 청년들의 정책에 대한 관심도 높여주는 효과를 가졌다고 볼 수 있습니다. 또 하나의 저희가 좀 기본소득을 하면서 의미가 있었던 것은 경기도 기본소득위원회 설치면 운영조례를 만들었다는 것입니다. 그 기본소득이란 단어를 저희가 자치법규인 조례로 명문화시켰다는 게 중요하다고 생각합니다.
In 2015, Prime Minister and government decided to run a basic income experiment. And there are several ways in which the basic income affects work incentives and hopefully on employment. And here are the measures of our survey. Satisfaction, trust, confidence, self-assessed health, ability to concentrate, stress, and financial well-being.
Whereby the same survey in the Netherlands has the same questions, but at the corporate level.
A symposium on innovation, and there was a survey at that time in the Netherlands asking young people, what do you want to do? What is your dream job? And 75% answered working in one of the big corporations. Whereby the same survey in the Netherlands asked the same question, but the result was that 70% of people, of the students, wanted to start their own business. Providing a basic income to the youth, and especially in Korea where this problem is paper safe, that could be, I think, a good way to experiment, and based also on the positive results achieved with this pilot.
If basic income, unconditional basic income, is meant for people to reorganize their life, re-engineer their life, and or even to go to labor market back, I think we need to give time. Investing in young people and psychologically making them feel that this country cares for you, and get into some kind of entrepreneurship or qualify yourself, train yourself. And a person like Mr. Governor Lee, I think, gives that kind of a hope about building a better society and a better future.